We continue our countdown to camp segments sponsored by Masterclass by talking about the wide receiver position. I'm Sierra Goodwill here with Evan Lazar. We're going through your burning questions surrounding the Patriots heading into training camp, and everyone loves to talk about undrafted free agents, and we're going to do that with Jeff Thomas here and Amari Bird, a first-year Patriot wide receiver that you're really high on. Let's start with him. Why do you like Bird and what his chances are to make this roster?
Well, the idea with both Bird and Thomas, I would say, being on the team right now, Sierra, is to replace Philip Dorsett, who obviously left for Seattle in free agency, and getting the Patriots somebody on the outside that has some speed. You know, last year, that wide receiver group especially was really hurting that they didn't have guys that could really take the top off the defense. You know, Dorsett was kind of the only one that was one of those faster, in that faster receiver type of mold. So they went out and they signed Bird and they signed Thomas as an undrafted free agent. With Bird, you know, they're really counting on one of these guys to break out and be that kind of speed threat for them, especially with Cam Newton at quarterback, to get those safeties to back off the line of scrimmage a little bit. With Bird, what I like so much about him, though, is that he adds another element in my mind than Philip Dorsett as an underneath yak type of receiver, right? Not just a guy that's going to win over the top on vertical routes. This is also somebody that you can throw the ball to on a screen or throw him on a shallow crossing route or a shallow route in general and watch him create with the ball in his hands after the catch. He's got punt return skills, he's got kick return skills, and those translate in the open field on offense as well. So a little bit more wiggle to him, I would say, than Philip Dorsett, who is kind of more of a straight line, linear type of receiver. Bird's a little bit more fluid. He's got a little bit more jump to his step, and I think that that might help him out to carve out a bigger role than Dorsett had, certainly, over the last couple of years.
And what we know about Jeff Thomas, the undrafted free agent, is that he had some sort of off-the-field issues in Miami in college. But people are really excited about his athleticism and potential if he's able to put his head down and work. But what disadvantage is he at with this crazy preseason and offseason where everything is really condensed and rushed with the ongoing pandemic?
A crazy disadvantage for everybody that's an undrafted free agent this season. The Patriots have that streak. I think we're at 17 seasons now of an undrafted free agent making the roster. This is really going to put it to the test because these guys have a month to prove their worth to Bill Belichick. With no preseason games and very few padded practices, they're going to have to make the team off of being very impressive just in the month of August in the practice fields behind Gillette Stadium. Now, with Jeff Thomas, I think that similarly to a guy like Bird, he also has a little bit of wiggle to him and a little bit of versatility where he can be that three-level threat to the defense instead of just being a vertical route runner. And he can also stretch the field horizontally, coming across the field on over routes or deep over routes, especially from the slot, where he was really effective at Miami as well. So he's got some more versatility to him. He's got more of a three-level game to him as well compared to Dorsett, who is really just intermediate comeback or deep route. Those were kind of his two things, were, you know, something towards the sideline on an intermediate level, or we're going deep with it. These two guys can do a little bit more than that. And I think the Patriots are looking for somebody that can be a little bit more versatile and be a little bit more electric with the ball in their hands. And I think both these guys can do that. And also didn't mention with Bird that he has played with Cam Newton before. He was in Carolina with Cam Newton for a couple of seasons. So they might have some chemistry there as well. And I think that both of these guys have an uphill battle to really make an impact on this team, because they're going to want to give snaps to N'Keal Harry. We know Julian Edelman's going to play a ton. We know Mohamed Sanu is probably going to fit in there somewhere as well. So we're really talking about the fourth or the fifth wide receiver on the depth chart. But I think both of these guys bring a speed element that the Patriots desperately need.
Well, this segment's been brought to you by Masterclass. Get unlimited access to every Masterclass. And as a Patriots Press Pass listener, you get 15% off the annual all-access pass. Just go to masterclass.com/CLNS. And for all of our countdown to camp coverage, find it on our website at clnsmedia.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Patriots Press Pass.